Now, Olympic swimming champion Libby Trickett has taken to social media to call out a family friend for commenting on her daughter's weight.
I had someone close to us say to my 8-year-old daughter today, "Wow, you look like you've lost weight. Have you lost weight? You look great."
Libby's with us now. Libby, what did you say to the friend who said this to your daughter?
Yeah, it's an interesting thing. I overheard the conversation, so I wasn't directly in it to begin with. And so in the moment, I didn't actually say anything. And I was really angry at myself for not saying something immediately. But I realised that it was probably for the best because I didn't want to make my daughter feel really uncomfortable in that situation and kind of really draw attention to it in that moment. But what I actually ended up doing was talking to my daughter later, checking in to see if she had heard the conversation or if she'd heard the comment, did it make her feel it any certain way? And, you know, just to reiterate to her that that's not how we talk about our bodies and that's not what is valuable, and that we focus on what our bodies are capable of and fueling our bodies as well as we possibly can. And then with the person close to us, we ended up having a conversation with them directly, and it actually went fairly well, surprisingly. I wasn't sure how it would be received. They are slightly older, so I wanted to make sure that we were respectful. And obviously different generations have different circumstances that they're brought up with and different values in different ways. So we wanted to make sure that it was very clear to them that this is not how we speak to our children. We do not discuss weight. We do not discuss bodies at all, or changes any which way.
Libby, I feel like you need a gold medal or two in patience as well in diplomacy. To have this happen to a little kid just blows my mind. But it's interesting, isn't it? Because some of these comments that happen at an early age, they can land and they can stick. I still remember comments made about my weight when I was a little girl, and they've stuck right through my 42 years on this earth. Do you remember the first comment about your body?
Yeah, I just got goosebumps, Sarah, because I think almost every woman on the planet has had a moment like that. Yeah. And for me, I was 10 years old, and it actually was a peer of mine, a little girl in my dance class, told me I looked chubby in the little leotard that I was wearing while I was dancing, and I quit dancing immediately. Oh. I stopped going and stopped enjoying it, and but it does. It knocks your confidence. It stops you from perhaps, you know, taking part in sport. It stops you from putting yourself forward as a leader, you know, putting yourself out there doing presentations at school. It really can significantly impact.
I just think you should get a mothering medal. You've handled this so brilliantly. Because you just don't know how early this seed is sown into a child's psyche. But what do you want to say to other people who might comment on the bodies of kids?
Oh, Kathy, that just means the absolute world to me. Thank you. I think it's we need to tackle it head on. And I think don't be afraid of messing up the conversation. I think we need to stop body commentary altogether because that is the least interesting thing about a person. Let's celebrate humour. Let's celebrate intelligence. Let's celebrate kindness. Yeah. Our bodies are the last on that list.
Yeah. Mind you, I'm very happy if Sam wants to tell me that I'm hot. That's fine. I will go with that.
Am I walking into a trap right now, Kathy?
Let's shut this down before I get it. Libby, thanks so much for speaking to us tonight. Really well played.
My absolute pleasure. Thanks for having me, guys.